Hey guys, I just finished the last episode of Rock Solid Friendship, and now I'm doing season 7, episode 5, Fluttershy Leans In. Feeling a little bit tired since this might be my last episode for the night. Trying to catch up, I'm far behind. Episode 10 came out, so. Season 7, episode 5, Fluttershy Leans In. I've seen some screenshots, but nothing really shows nothing, so. I don't know what the episode's about, so on and so forth. So, yeah. Oh, try again. Try again. Don't lock. There you go. Good. Anyway, see how this episode goes. Trying to mute the intro this time. And, stuff like that. Alright, here we go.
Play the push the play button and stuff right there.
Okay. Oh, there. Sound. Okay. Anyway, some kind of training thing? Okay, why? Eh, he's tough. Oh, or not.
I told you that entering the Ponyville parkour contest was a dangerous idea. You just rest here, and I'll have you all fixed up in no time. Oh dear, I'm all out of bunny foot braces. I think we need to pay a visit to Dr. Fauna.
Fine. Okay, sure. I haven't heard of this person before. I'm gonna tear it. Dr. Fauna.
Fluttershy? Oh, am I glad to see you!
Okay.
I wish I could say the same, but the door is stuck, so I, can't see you.
Oh, some bunny hurt his foot. Let's bandage that up so we can get back home. I'd like to keep him overnight, but as you can see, my place is just bursting with animals! I don't think I can take in even one more critter right now.
A giraffe? Okay. Well, okay. Fluttershy and Doctor. Sure. Whatever. Sounds like something that I haven't seen before, so stuff. See what's up. Or vet. All right, is he eating the cotton?
This place is like a zoo. Then again, it's normally like that, but still, I can't keep up. Oh, now there's my favorite little bunny. What a carrot pop.
Okay, well.
That's okay. I think the goats ate all of them anyway. Ailments, hurt wings, stuffy noses, and such. But the trouble is, even after there all healed up? I can't seem to get these comfy critters to leave.
Oh, dear.
Get out of here.
They do seem to have made themselves right at home here.
Yeah.
I wonder why they chose to flock to my office. It just doesn't make sense.
Don't be silly, Dr. Fauna. You're the best vet pony in Equestria. At least that's what I've been telling every pony.
You did what?
Oh, no. Do you suppose it's my fault? Barley. So sorry.
Not,
I didn't mean
sort
to
of, kind of, Barley, not really.
I just feel safe and happy under your care.
Normally, I don't mind if a snake wants to slither in or a raccoon needs a rest, but now this place is so full, I have no space to treat any injured animals.
That is a big problem. Then I'm going to fix for you. I already have the perfect solution that'll make the critters happy and give you more space. Then you'll have all your ducks in a row.
You fix it, the
better. Yeah.
I want to thank you all for rushing right over when I called. Dr. Fauna needs my help with a serious problem.
A friendship problem?
No.
No, her vet clinic is a bit, maybe, overrun with adorable critters in dire need of a safe place to lay their heads, and they don't have anywhere to go.
Oh, that's just awful.
I know.
Yeah, Dr. Fauna's always fixing Winona up when she ain't feeling too fine, so helping her out is a-okay by me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll help you.
Oh, that's great news. Because it means you'll all be helping me with something special, too. Something that's been a dream of mine for a long time.
Oh, goody! Is your dream to make a bouncy castle shaped like a gigantic bundt cake?
No. Not exactly.
Oh, just me, then.
So, what is it, Fluttershy? Spill!
My dream is to build a real animal sanctuary. A beautiful habitat where every animal, whether sick, scared, or even just lonely, feathered or furry, scaly or slimy, every critter would be welcome. My sanctuary can be the one place in Equestria they call home till they feel ready to take on the world.
Wow, Fluttershy. I've never heard you speak with such conviction.
That was exquisite.
Pretty awesome.
Thank you, every pony. You've all taught me so much about building my confidence over the years. It's because of your friendship that I finally feel able to make my dream project a reality. But I can't build the sanctuary alone. Will you join me?
Oh, God! I'm happy to offer my extra hooves to you. But come to think of it, I actually know a filly who'd be more help than I would. She's a friend of mine from Winona's sheep herding competition. Wrangler. She's an expert in animal enclosures.
Okay.
Lovely.
Oh, I know some pony too. Hard Hat is the best construction pony in Ponyville. He can build anything you could ever want.
Okay.
Hearing you all mention these experts, I am reminded that I too have the perfect pony to help capture the essence of your vision.
What?
Some style, some flair.
Why am I?
Is it you, Rarity?
Premier interior designer of the Canterlot Elite, Dandy Grandeur. He helped me when I was setting up my Canterlot boutique. I know he'd be thrilled to work with you.
I get the feeling of the boutique situation with Rarity before, where it all came together and became chaos.
We're right on track to building the most wonderful sanctuary in Equestria.
And it's going to be a whole bunch of chaos. Right? Like Rarity's boutique.
It's wonderful that you all could join me to discuss the Ponyville Sanctuary Project. My friends have so many nice things to say about each of your talents. This is a big project, so I'm happy to have such experienced ponies working on it with me.
Rarity has impeccable taste in design and friends, so I can't wait to work with you, you know?
New ponies.
I think so.
Yeehaw! I'm just looking forward to helping you out, ma'am. And the animals.
Of course.
Okay.
So, Pinkie Pie said you drew up some blueprints?
Not exactly. It's more of a dream board.
They've got the paddock cabbage knee. It's a bit
that
chaos.
Sure doesn't look like an animal hospital.
Well, that's because it's not. It's a sanctuary. A place that is safe but not restrictive. Cozy but natural. A place where the animals can come and go as they please.
You kind of need more of an outline.
Can you build it?
Oh boy. You gotta have the it's gotta be more well defined.
I want the sanctuary to have an open floor plan. No walls. More like an enclosure that melts into the trees. With a gate in the back. That way, the animals can return to the forest right when they feel ready.
Sneaky! I like it!
You know, I designed the Ponyville Hospital. I could do the exact same thing right here. I still have the blueprints. Though, it'll take a while to clear all these trees.
But I don't want to clear the trees. I want to use them.
Are you sure? What you're talking about doesn't really seem like a cohesive structure. Or any structure I'm familiar with.
Critters don't live the same way ponies do. I know this is unconventional. That's because we're trying to do something that's never been done before. I really believe it'll work.
All right, then. I'll see what I can do.
See, Fluttershy? Whatever you want.
Good.
I know she thinks she knows what's best, but once she sees how much better it works with these plans, she'll thank us.
I had a feeling it was going to be chaos.
Which one do you like for the window treatments?
Ooh, loving the print on those!
Not to be rude, but there must be some mistake. We have no need for curtains at the sanctuary.
And why ever not?
Everything is going to look natural in the animal habitats, not like it was made for ponies.
All those shades of brown and green, but they're so drab, you know?
Drab? You're calling the colors of beautiful trees drab?
Exactly. The natural look is not in right now. This is better. Trust me.
Goodness, have a good sniggy.
I appreciate your input, but I just know the animals would be happiest with dirt brown pillows and leaf green accents.
I'll look into it.
Thank you.
When a client has a vision.
Sometimes they need me to steer them away from it. Especially its dirt brown.
And right there we got your standard sheet tracking page. Fits to critters depending on size.
What is it, Sugar Cube?
I'm looking for something less like a cage, more like a nice hug. Maybe if we lose that part.
Well, then it wouldn't be a cage.
Exactly. Ooh, this is the perfect base for a little nest. I'll take a bunch of these, and anything else the animals can burrow into.
You sure you don't want something more secure for the critters? She does have a point there. You wouldn't want a bunny wandering into the wrong cave, would you?
No. No cages. I want to give the animals the freedom to come and go. It's the only way they'll feel comfortable.
Well, she's the boss.
It's gonna be a big mess. Oh well, they'll figure out to do the right thing. And
hey, what do you think, Fluttershy? I told you we'd be fast. Almost finished with the building already.
The color just pops, you know?
Quite roomy inside, really, and very safe.
Don't keep us waiting, Fluttershy. Do you love it, or do you love it?
I don't love it. This is not going to work at all. A giraffe can't fit through this door. With these curtains blocking the light, how are the birds going to sing in the sunshine? And this is the opposite of a nice hug. I know you all worked hard, but none of you did anything I asked for.
That's not true. We used the trees just like you asked.
And that curtain fabric is organic. It's got natural fibers.
And I added pillows inside my cages. That should count as feeling like a hug.
I may not know much about construction, or interior design, or wrangling, but I am an expert at one thing. The care of animals. And what animals need is a sanctuary, not this!
Maybe your vision wasn't all it was cracked up to be, you know?
My vision isn't the problem here. I told you all exactly what I wanted, and none of you listened to me! So while I appreciate your efforts, I no longer require your services.
Hello! Oh, the animals have been so excited for the sanctuary, they couldn't wait any longer. Can we take a look inside?
Oh, actually, it's, not ready, and...
Commence the chaos. Well, as long as nobody was hurt, then it deserved to be destroyed. Actually, it's just stuff.
Sleep tight, little one. It's going to be okay. I promise.
You gotta give people what they ask for.
Every mouse has gotta wait their
or
turn.
Ponies.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I thought I'd have a beautiful sanctuary for you all to stay in by now. But I put my trust in the wrong pony.
It's okay, Fluttershy. I know you did your best. But we can make this work here. It'll be a bit, tight. But with your help, we'll have these patients back on their paws in no time. Even without a sanctuary.
No! I won't give up. These animals need me. And I'm gonna solve this once and for all. If this little lady can crawl all the way here from Western Equestria, I can find a way to build her a safe place to rest!
Use the animals. Use the animals.
Oh. Oops. Everyone back to sleep now.
Thanks for coming,
Everypony. As you know, building the sanctuary didn't go quite as planned.
I know, right? Who would have guessed that Hard Hat wouldn't build whatever you want?
I never would have invited Dandy to help if I thought he'd act in such a manner.
And Wrangler sure made a fool out of me, too. I'm sorry, Fluttershy.
It's okay. You were all just trying to help. But I know that letting all the experts go was the right call.
So what are you gonna do now?
Try again. I'm going to rebuild the sanctuary and do it my way this time.
Fluttershy! How about putting an awesome flying course for the birds right there? And a carrot cake stand here! Ooh, a library cave?
Stop! I appreciate you sharing your thoughts, but I need every pony to respect mine. Other ponies may be experts in their fields, but animals are my field of expertise. And if I say this is what I want, then this is what needs to happen! For the animals, of course.
Wow! We should call you Flutter Bold now!
To get things back on track, I called in a favor from an old friend. He'll be here any minute.
I thought you said no more experts.
This is
is one expert I know I can trust to put the animals first. Plus, there's no pony better at building.
Okay.
Some pony needs construction help for their printer.
Okay.
Daddy McCool.
That works.
We met each other back when the map called me and Fluttershy to the Smoky Mountains. And he certainly knows his stuff when it comes to buildings and caring for animals.
Well, shucks.
Yeah.
Let's not stand around talking about it. Let's build us a sanctuary.
Been a while since I've seen him. Man. If you want something made your way, you gotta be there every step of the way. Otherwise, it ain't gonna be made your way. CMC, why not? A pillow for whatever, I guess.
Are you ready?
Oh, I'm more excited than a beaver in a log pile.
Okay, you can open your eyes. Welcome to Sweet Feather Sanctuary.
Nice.
This is amazing.
Now you should have plenty of room at the clinic, because once you've treated them, they can recover here. With my help, of course.
Sloth.
It's okay, Lola. We all move at our own pace. All we need to do is believe in our dreams. And when we finally reach our goal, we'll know that it was worth what it took to get there. Because the view will be even better than you imagined.
Pretty cool episode. Eh. Go away. Yeah, good episode. Fluttershy wanted to make a sanctuary for the animals, and she did so. Something like that in real life would take time and effort. Reminds me of me rebuilding my house. Man, I live in a mobile home that needs a... come on, stop being a... Nah. Stop it. Nah. Thing. Anyway, I got a lot of repairs in my house. I want to eventually make my house the way it should be. Yeah. Anyway. Well, good episode. Fluttershy, what's her name, the doctor, vet, whatever. And, nothing extraordinary, just good. Not quite as good as the last episode, but good. So, yeah. Don't know how my reactions are, but, whatever, I'm just trying. Whatever's clever. Anyway. Guess I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.